see. Let me back you up a little bit. Back up. Okay. So, this is something that was sent to me by a company on Amazon. Something that I use quite often, and I was very honored for them choosing me to do this unboxing. So, Mr. Allen, thank you so much for choosing me for this unboxing. This is, I did receive this for free. I am going to do an honest review. And after I'm done with it, I'm going to repackage it and I'm going to use it as a giveaway for a drawing contest at my local high school. So I'm not actually even keeping it. So I'm super excited because now I have a present to give them when they win the contest. Okay, so let's get to it. Everybody know that lately I have been doing diamond paints. Oh, I have to say, it did come like this without, it wasn't sealed or sealed down like this. It was like this, unfortunately. Okay. So, everybody know that I have been doing diamond paintings lately. For the last couple of years or a year or so, whatever. And so, I was kindly sent this A4 light pad. This is a battery operated light pad. So the thing that I love the most about the whole thing is that it's battery operated. So I'm not tethered to a cord all the time. I need a bigger one than this one, which is one of the reasons why I'm going to give it away, because I need a bigger size. But this is an A4 size. Okay. As you can see, it is brand spanking new. I have not used it yet. I wanted to let this be an honest review of what I'm receiving. Okay. First and foremost, let's see what we got. Okay, we got the light pad. These are perfect for 30 by 40s, especially 30 going this way and 40 going this way, because this is the orientation. But you could always use it this way if you needed to. So this is perfect for those 30 by 40s, those snack size. Really perfect. It comes with an eraser, a pencil sharpener, because this is the pencil, because it's used, this is, they're normally used for drawing. We in the crafty world have gotten them where we use them for diamond art. Excuse me, but they're normally for drawing, and you put your paper underneath and your carbon on top. Okay, so let's see what we got. Okay, the drawing pencil, it is USB-C look like, which is really good. That's really starting to be the most popular thing. Yep, it's USB-C, so you're not trying to use older technology, as it were. Okay, so it's got a nice long cord too. I was thinking the cord was going to be small, but it's not. It's a nice long cord. Look at that. Okay, so I have a USB thingy right in front of me. Excuse all my head working over here in the way. I'm trying to reach this USB. Yeah, did I turn it on? Nope, just turned it off. Okay. So we won't use this because we're diamond painting. Then we have, of course, our instructions. And you need to pull off the film. I'm not going to pull it off because I want the student, whoever wins it, to have a fresh device. Okay? And then this, just, you see that there? This is the USB-C port. And this is the on and off switch. Did you see that? It's blinking because it's charging. See the angle? It's already tilted for you, which is a plus when you're working, so your hand is not flat. Because when you draw, of course, you know anybody who draws needs that tilt. Okay? Then all you do is push this button and you see the light changing. 3, 4, 5, off. So that's off. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and off. So it has 5 different settings. Okay, first of all, I like the settings because sometimes when I'm diamond painting, I need those extra settings. So I'm about to grab just a random diamond painting that I have on my shelf so we can see the difference. Okay, so this is a nice little 30 by 40 or 40 by 30. So 40 by 30. This is just one of those diamond paintings that I picked up off of Amazon. And let me do this. I just turned off my lights. Look how good you can see this. Look how wonderful and easy you can see those symbols. So you're seeing exactly what I'm seeing. So this is just the first one. Let's go higher. Oh, wow. It gets even better when you go brighter. Look at that. I just went brighter. Let's go brighter. Because that's two. That's three. Four. That's five, and that's off. So even at the one, you can see it really good. So three is generally where I usually land at when I'm working because I also have a light on. So you can tell this is really good. If you were working on this and you don't mind it hanging off, it's really not that bad to use a 40 by 30. This is the perfect size for that. Let me turn my lights back on. This is the perfect size for that. Okay, we also have these little magnets. Let's see if they work. So if you're working, if you're working on your diamond painting and you got it on there. Okay, let's see. Let's see where we catch the magnet. We catch the magnet about right there. And you see, I can catch the magnet right here, but it's not that strong. Okay. I'm catching the magnets in this area here. So, we still got a lot of room over here that's not really catching the magnets. There is more like central. And I'm feeling these magnets. These magnets are not that good. Look at this. It's holding it on here, but the magnets are not that good because it should not have slid. The magnet should not have slid right down. See, I'm not even getting any magnification right there. It's holding it on here, but these magnets, I can tell they're not that good. The strength of the magnet on which part, I'm not really sure, but the magnets are not that good. So, I wouldn't use these. I generally use clips anyway. So I would clip one of those duck bill clips or whatever on the side of this, which I think they'll stay on here. Let me look for one of my diamond paintings and see. Okay, let me pause you while I go get a clip and see what it looks like, if it'll work. Let me pause you. Okay, I'm back with clips. Okay, so I have this clip that I use. It's the one that you use for sewing. Then these office bill clips. And then these are the ones from the Dollar Tree or whatever, the dollar store. And these are the potato chip. So I use all of these in my diamond paintings. So let's see what we'll get. If we take this one, can we clip it here? No. No, we won't be able to clip it at the top. Let's see if we can clip it on the side, which is generally where I clip the most. If it's on the side and the bottom one, it lays down. So we got some good clips. We know we can't clip this one on the top. So let's see if we can clip this securely on the side. So if you move down, let's see. You can clip that one on the side. But it's kind of awkward because it's clipped all the way open. So I wouldn't use that. So far, this is the winner right here. These clips is the winner, but not on the top. Okay. So let's see this one. Okay, this one clips. Let's see if it'll clip on this top part. I don't have any hope. Nope, it'll stay, but it's clipped all the way open. I don't like that part. But this one has plenty of room, plenty of grab, but it'll slide off. So your best bet with the clipping is to clip on the sides, not necessarily on the top. Plus, if you're using something that you're rolling forward, you're not going to clip on the top anyway. But it clips perfectly fine on the sides with these clips. You can't clip on the top, though. See that? I can't clip this on the top. I can clip on the top with this one, though. Nope. You know why? It's making it tip up. So that wouldn't be helpful. So looks like you can clip only on the side too. It starts with the tilt. Also, you can put it in a stand and clip it to the stand. So I like this. I like this for smaller jobs. So like if I was working with this and I wanted to keep it all on here, I would run it this way just to make it easier and keep everything in inside of there. But unfortunately, if you do that, there's nowhere to clip. See that? And with the magnets not being very strong, that's not helpful. Okay? So it's going to be better to use it this way. But it'll clip on and it'll stay on. And this, it's no problem laying it this way, especially if you're using a 40 by 30 or 30 by 40. It'll be okay because you can clip it in two spots and lay this down, because that's the key. You clipping it and you laying that back piece down, so then this stays flat. That's what you really need. You need to make sure that it's level. Okay, but this is pretty good. Let's see, do I have enough juice? Okay, it ain't gonna just pull out, but look at that. It's enough juice. Let's take the lights off. Look at that. It has enough juice. And I didn't plug it up beforehand. Y'all see me just take it out of the bag. But look at that. It still has enough juice to light your way. I'm not sure how long this battery lasts. Let's see what the hours, if it'll tell us the hours that it lasts. Lifetime, 390 minutes. That's the lifetime of this. 5 dimmers that can be optional. Hold down the power switch to adjust brightness. Under normal conditions, 5 to 6 hours can be used after charging for 2 hours. So if you charge it for 2 hours, you can use it for 5 to 6 hours without having to charge it again. It's a lithium battery and it's a bright pad, and you know, most cartoonists and animation people use these. But look how bright that is. I don't know what kind of charge it got on right now, because this is the charge from the box. But if it has such a great charge from the box, this is great. I love it. It's too small for me because I usually do bigger paintings like the Train of Dreams that you've seen. But this is wonderful. I love it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the link in the description box so that you can go to Amazon and check it out for yourself. Matter of fact, let me show you where you can find it. This is what it looks like. Y'all, peep the price. Custom light, tracing pad, drawing surface, dimmable. I think this is the right one. Let's see. Is this the right store? Nope. Yeah, this is the right store. And if not, I'll send you the link. You know what? Let me do this. Let me put in the link name. It's TOHETO. TOHETO. Like A2, We're going to look up the A2, but we really want A4. But these are the results. A2, this is their light pad. Let me put, that's supposed to say A4. A4 light pad. There we go. That's more like the business. Okay. Because this is it. It's $39.99. It's a rechargeable. And look it. You can get 20% off. You can get 20% off if you click on there. I'm not sure how long that lasts, but 20% is 20%. As of the taping of this video on November the 4th, Friday, November the 4th at 11:28. I'm doing a late video and I'm going to put this up right now because I spoke to them and I told them I would have it up today. And I was busy all day because we had to move our offices because we had to move out of our WeWorks location because they sold the building and blah, blah, blah. So here you go. This is a winner. I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it. I can honestly say that I love this. Okay, let me take you back to the screen. I really do love this light pad. And the gentleman, Mr. Allen, from TOHETO, probably not pronouncing it right. I'm going to put a description in the description, a link in the description box on where you can find this light pad. And I thank you so much for allowing me to be able to give my honest review. I love wireless things because I'm always on the move and I need things that can move with me. And this is perfect. Mr. Allen, when you see this video, send me the bigger size so I can check that one out too. Because this one is going to be given away to the school. They will appreciate it and I will make sure that I tell them it was from your organization. But if you want me to review another one, send me the bigger size because I do bigger paintings. I thank you so much. And I thank y'all all for being on my channel, hanging in there with me. I got a lot of videos that's coming. So thank you so much for joining me. And I will see y'all in the next one.